That just
we're live
right now.
Live. All right, is it
on the
supposed
internet?
To be this loud?
Yeah, this is loud.
All right, let's do it. Welcome in.
This shit is all the way up.
People can see this.
We
shit.
Are loud as fuck. The Yak is live. Live from Full Circle Bar in Williamsburg.
This was a mistake.
Ski Ball National Championship.
Oh, that's good.
Which I found out when we showed up.
That's
it
good.
Actually isn't the Ski Ball National Championship. It's just a pay-per-view match where you don't have to pay. But we're here. We're live. The Yak. Welcome in, everyone. Welcome.
Boys. It's the rematch. The kid versus the cat.
Jesus Christ. That's
too loud. Too loud.
Jesus Christ.
That's loud. Maybe a little, maybe a little less of me.
Oh, my God.
Maybe a little less of me.
I appreciate Roan's enthusiasm.
I was whispering.
Everyone just, you know.
Let's do a whisper show.
Let's not talk.
Don't get too close to the mic. Don't get too close to the mic.
I'm all the way back. Let's just take it easy.
I'm a little bit poppy as well.
Yeah, a little poppy. That's okay.
It's just the headphones.
The mics sound fine. All right. As long as
the people
at home. We can blow out our eardrums as long as the people at home enjoy it. All right, so we're going to have the competitors on the show, but
yeah.
We first have to talk about, KB, I want you to explain it, because on the way here today, I was actually saying to myself, why am I doing this? Mm-hmm. And then I remembered it's because you got fascinated with skee ball for one day, mm-hmm. like 6 months ago.
And it's surreal to see the people I've discovered. I've made them famous, and they're here in the flesh. Elon... Mr. Futterman, why don't you take the
wait,
stage?
Wait, no, this is revisionist history, because I remember you said, would you rather find $20 on the ground or be the best skee ball player in the world?
Well, I mean.
And then we found these guys.
you actually, you were a dick.
I found him, and I Googled him.
All right, so yeah,
this is the guest mic.
Yeah, all right, so this is.
The guest mic can be on camera.
This is our first competitor tonight, so it's the matchup is Joey the Cat. Versus the skee ball kid. This is the skee ball kid. So the background for everyone, and we'll say it a couple times so people feel invested in the match. The skee ball kid is the up-and-comer. He beat Joey the Cat in the World Championship in 2019. Stunner. Joey the Cat is the GOAT. He's like 35. Skee ball kid's 22. He only goes for hundos. He goes full send. So this is the first time they're playing each other after the World Championship in 2019. 2020 got vacated because of COVID. Am I right?
Yeah, so this is the first competitive skee ball match since then.
Okay.
They have had the league finish up since then, but this is the first big individual competition.
Yep.
So big stuff.
Yeah, that was a great explanation. All right, so KB, do you want to take it?
Because
this is your thing.
I Googled the best skee ball player in the world. He was the first to come up. Joey the Cat was the second. I don't know.
Wow.
But
that might be an SEO.
Whoa.
Thing.
Yeah,
that could be
SEO.
SEO.
Yes. Pay-per-click.
And what a venue to host such a prestigious event.
So you were sitting. So skee ball kid, you were sitting at home one day, just randomly, and you're just, you know, you're trying to mind your own business. You're a world champion, you know, but a regular guy. Like, would it be safe to say that the fame of having a skee ball world championship has not gone to your head?
Yeah.
Like,
no,
you still live at your parents' house, like, you know.
Yeah, so I graduated college.
Get right up in that mic.
I graduated college in 2020. I moved back in, you know, with my parents. I've been working out of home. I'm actually moving out next week. But
oh, fuck.
Congratulations.
Let's hear it for the kid.
Go get you some pussy.
Let's hear it for dad.
But yeah, I mean, outside of the arcade, I'm just a normal guy. When I go to the arcade, everyone comes up to me and they're like, how are you so good at skee ball? But everywhere else, it's just a normal guy.
What is the arcade?
So the arcade I go to is in Point Pleasant, New Jersey. Mm. So it's like 2 hours from here.
What's it called?
Jenkinson's Boardwalk.
Oh, of course, yeah.
So one of the arcades that I go to, there's a 600-point jackpot, so I go there, I play, I get some tickets, and, you know, save them up, get some big stuff. I've got, like, TVs, iPads, Xboxes, you
damn.
Name it. So,
goddamn.
Yeah, I just go there and play, and people, I don't know, they just come up to me, and they're
put
like,
put your face all the way down on the mic. That's what
no,
that
he's good.
Is.
I think
the
he's
audio
good.
The guy with the blue hair wants to put
okay?
the whole face on the mic.
I can't hear it anymore.
Yeah.
That's
sorry.
Are you listening on the YouTube? Oh, the audio's good. Okay, all right. So, Skee Ball Kid, So you're now rise to stardom, and KB finds you on this random day, and your world basically changes forever, correct? What'd you gain, like a couple hundred more followers?
I was at 100 followers by the end of the day. I was at like 600.
Damn.
Damn.
Yeah, that
damn.
Sounds.
Damn.
That's
100%
of our listeners.
Who's that girl? You winked at her when she came.
That's KB the Rainmaker. That's KB the Rainmaker.
That's Sarah.
Okay,
you
that's your friend. You winked at her when she
you
came
know
in.
That.
That was nice.
KB's
I got a lot
like
of
the Lou Pearlman of skee ball.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah.
He's
yeah.
much like the Lou Pearlman of skee ball.
So do you guys have like a shit-talking relationship? What is your relationship with this cat?
I think it's like friendly shit talk. Like, you know, we joke with each other, but ultimately there's a lot of respect. I mean, two guys who are the best in the game, you got to respect it. But
are you better
definitely
than
some
him?
Competition.
Are you better?
Oh.
I mean, 2019 says so, but we'll see what happens tonight.
Okay,
We're both very good players, so I mean, it could really go either way.
Okay, and so we I said it before that we're playing for $200, which is a joke. So we're going to we'll up that. We'll do $1,200.
Okay. Let's make it $1,500. Let's make it $1,500.
Let's make it 2,000.
Let's make it 20k.
Okay, 2,000 bucks.
My accountant, you
yeah.
can't do that.
We're doing 20.
$2,000.
Can he swing
$2,000. $2,000 on the line. And the loser has to come into the office tomorrow and do Pick Central with Ben Mintz. Mm-hmm. And the winner gets to come on the Yak.
First of all, that's a good show, too.
It's a great show.
That's a decent show.
It's a win-win.
The loser has to suffer through Pick
Central.
Do you
understand
the
disparity?
Yeah. You should.
No idea.
If you're on you will lose all 60 people that followed you.
It's a Lamborghini and a bicycle. So
not really a bike. It's more like a Toyota Camry.
Yeah, okay. Toyota Camry. There. Yeah, yeah. Gotcha. With like Barney Rubble where you have to use your feet to get anywhere.
Much like that.
Yes, much like that. All right, so that's going to be what's at stake. $2,000, all the pride in the world, and the loser has to suffer through Pick Central. And the winner
is Rico
on it, too?
That's fair.
Yes, Rico's there tomorrow.
Rico,
you'll be with Rico, Marty Mush, and Ben Mintz.
Hey, buddy,
that's
if you lose,
Rico's going to be there.
There's chance for the skee ball kid.
They're going nuts for the skee ball kid.
He's got a policy.
No. A riot has broken out.
Do you feel like that gives you a competitive edge, the fact that you got your friends in the building?
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, it pumps me up.
Yeah, it fires you up.
We don't know that the cat doesn't have people here, too.
I mean, he's coming all the way from San Fran, so he has some people, but
so the
a lot of my friends are from
where's the cat?
Brooklyn.
Yeah, but they're
anybody
San Franciscans.
Where's the cat?
Where is the cat?
Oh, wow.
No cat?
Unleash the cat.
Is anyone here for us?
No, yeah, absolutely not.
Is that the cat right there?
The one dude. So you said that everybody asks you, how did you get good at skee ball? Whenever you're playing in front of people or you surprise some people, what's the answer to the question? How did you get so good at such a young age? You're like a prodigy.
Yeah, I mean, I lived, you know, in Edison, but I'd go and visit Point Pleasant every year during the summer. And starting from when I was 4 or 5, my parents would give me $5, spent on whatever you wanted, the boardwalk. Skee ball was the cheapest thing. So I played a lot of skee ball. And then after Hurricane Sandy, they redid one of the machines, or one of the arcades. They got new machines. They had a jackpot. So if you get 300 points, you get a bunch of bonus tickets. So I went, and I was getting jackpots left and right. I walked away as a 14-year-old with an iPad mini that summer.
Oh, let's go.
And then, you know, of course, I'm going to keep coming back. So it just kind of went from there.
So have you furnished your whole house with tickets?
Hurricane Sandy was more of a positive experience.
Like yeah, it was. My house
so Hurricane Sandy was
one of the better things that happened to you.
Actually. I don't know if I go that far.
That was the Hurricane Sandy was the best thing that's ever
without
happened.
It wasn't some bad for me.
Tragedy has been good things to people here. Yeah. Kyle, Mr. Bauer.
KB.
Without Hurricane Sandy, things would have been different. But what do you think it is? What do you attribute it to? Is it just you have the magic touch? I see your fingernails are the shiniest. You're so like, what is it called? It's not collagen. What's the stuff? Keratin. You're keratin rich.
Yeah.
You just have so much keratin. You think that has something to do with it or what?
I think I've just had a competitive nature, and I always like to get really good at what I do. So I think that's where it came from.
So, Skee Ball Kid, last question. So when we're about to, like, so how it's going to go for everyone's watching at home, after the show finishes at 9, the actual championship will be on the stream, so you don't have to go anywhere. We're all going up to sit in the bleachers to watch, to heckle, to do everything. So your style, you go for full send hundreds every time. Mm-hmm.
So I actually go for a hybrid approach. So I start with hundreds.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Dan,
oh,
you just sounded so fucking strategy. You just sound like
such a noob. This is probably my first time watching skee ball.
You're right, though. Hundreds are my thing.
No, don't pander. Don't patronize me.
But I do
no,
go for a hybrid that. Approach.
You were right. Kind of.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll start for the hundreds. I'll hit them while I'm hot. And then once I start cooling off, if I miss a couple, I'll switch to the 40s and 50s, get some guaranteed points. And that's how I won in 2019 is – you know, you could go for hundreds and it's high risk, high reward. But if you do the hybrid, you're able to, like, manage some of that risk.
And what was the final score in 2019?
I think it was, like, 419 to 412, something around
that. Oh, so close.
Close.
It came down to the last ball.
Wow.
Joey the Cat needed 100 on the last one.
And he choked.
Bounced off the wall. And he just missed.
Damn, you think you could give us a toss before you get out of here? You think you could give us just, like, a throw over here? And
yeah.
The
show
Mr. Ball, you have a different technique, right? You almost go a bowling technique, do you not?
Yeah.
Everybody else stands still, but you're an active guy.
Yeah, so I'm the only one that takes a set when I throw, as far as I know.
Is that illegal?
It's not it's illegal, like as long as you stay in the box.
In football?
They have to rewrite everything. The rules. Yeah. It's like George
It's almost
Mike
like you don't know the rules.
Yeah.
You know, when I came in here, I was told you can't be good, you can't be the best because you have too much movement.
Who told you that?
The haters.
Everyone who saw me in the bar the first time I walked in here.
Right.
Wow.
They were all like, you got to change your stance. You'd be so good if you change your stance.
Wow.
I stuck to my guns and it worked out.
Look
so.
At that. I love that story. All right. You want to throw one?
Yeah, give us, let's see it. Give us 100. Give us 100.
Let's get 100.
Why not?
Give us 100.
Why not 100?
Give us 100.
Righty or lefty? He said righty or lefty.
Where are those chants at? Where are the chants at?
They're one righty, one lefty.
Ski ball kid.
He said
righty or lefty. Wait, is he switched?
He said righty or lefty.
He's an ambidextrous hybrid.
I don't know if we can see it on the, oh no, we got it. We got the mic. All right, here we go. Here's ski ball kid going for a little practice.
This is righty.
Oh. Okay, okay.
Oh.
Oh!
This is your guy.
I
this is your guy, Kyle.
Again, this doesn't matter. This is just practice. Right,
this is a warm-up.
Where's Joey the cat? Where is he?
They say ski ball's 90%.
Oh. All right, there's 100.
Go lefty, go lefty.
Lefty, lefty. Lefty.
Oh,
okay.
He's going for strong. Those hundreds.
It's not going to hit every time.
Dude,
it's not
going to
hit every time. High risk. He's talking about winning iPad minis. Right now he can get like a Tootsie Pop and a spider ring.
All right. All right, so there is Ski Ball Kid.
Let's go, Ski Ball Kid.
Competitor number one. Thank you, Ski Ball Kid.
Good shit, brother. Good stuff.
Appreciate it. All right, so let's get Joey the Cat up here.
Ski Ball Kid is also in the building with his dad.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Ski Ball Dad.
Yeah, Ski Ball Dad.
Is your dad your coach?
His dad's coach.
His dad is the coach.
It's a Tiger Woods and...
If you see a horseshoe on the bottom right of your screen...
Yeah, I actually saw his dad hunting
Ski
for pussy before this, so it's very much an Earl Woods, Tiger Woods thing. Yeah.
Ski Ball Dad loved the Earl Woods joke.
He actually came up to me, he's like, where can I get some pussy around here? I'm like, Jesus Christ, Ski Ball Dad.
He was pulling a you-know-who-I-am type maneuver.
Yeah.
You know, I'm Ski Ball Kid's dad.
Do you know who my son
is? I'm Ski Ball father.
You must know my boy Ski Ball. My son.
All right, so here we go. We got Joey the Cat.
This fucking guy.
Joey the Cat
is... Let's go, Cat. Let's go, Joey the Cat.
You can tell me if I'm wrong here. But Joey the Cat, you are the GOAT, correct? Like, you have the most world championships in ski ball?
Yeah, I've got 3 national ski ball championships.
Okay, 3 of them. What years?
2011, 2012, 2014.
Ooh. So it's been a while.
It's been 7 years.
Thanks for the reminder.
I'm just saying. Okay, it's been a while. People are asking.
Yeah, I mean, I made it to the semifinals and the finals pretty much almost every year. And then obviously the finals in 2019 when I played the kit.
Right. Okay, so you are the older guy on the scene. You have the rings to match up the talk. And you lost to Ski Ball Kid on the last throw, 2019. And this is your first match against him. Is your first match since then, period?
I've played him 1 match in my career. This will be the 2nd match in my career ever playing the Ski Ball Kid. He's a newcomer on the circuit. So,
do you think that's kind of like, has he earned his stripes?
He earned his stripes, definitely.
Is there an anger behind your words tonight about?
I'm going for the jugular. That's what we're doing here.
But here's the other thing. You remind me a little bit of Joey Chestnut. You lost in the 2019 final because you had a kid 3 days before and then flew to the championship.
Oh, wow.
It's kind of like when Joey Chestnut lost. The only time he lost was in his stretch was after his girlfriend broke up with him. His fiance broke up with him a week before.
Why do you know that?
Which is messed up of her.
He's the greatest of all time.
Yeah, he's a goat.
Right. So you had, this was obviously a lot more joyous because you had a child, but there was family things that you had to come out here, compete, lost.
Yeah, I mean, shout out to my wife and my little baby boy, Leo.
Leo.
My wife had just had Leo, and we were out of the hospital for 3 days, and I flew out here on a red eye, totally jet lagged, and was the number one seed in that tournament, and then made it to the finals, and that's when the kid match happened.
Can you tell us what the scene's like? What's the scene like? There's people out here that don't give a damn that we're on the radio. All they care about is that you're throwing balls tonight and that you're going for that ship, that it's the rematch. People love you.
Yeah, I mean, it's electric out here. There's a lot of fervor, a lot of excitement. It is a title match.
Right.
The kid has put his title on the line, which mad respect to the kid for that.
Mad respect to the kid.
Because we've had a pandemic in between our last match, which was hard for me, an arcade operator. I run an arcade business for a living, so I haven't made any money in the last 16 months. So this is sort of a beautiful
moment. So you need
moment.
That 2,000. You heard they bumped it to 2,000. It was 200. Now it's 2,000.
2,200.
Order of magnitude higher. I like that.
Exactly. I can't go any higher.
We'll move some things.
Yeah, we'll some things. $2,000. The winner, it's going to be $2,000, and the loser has to do Pick Central. Brandon's show.
It's a great show.
And should we make him do wrestling too?
Oh,
no,
that is the last nail in the coffin career-wise.
That'd be super cruel.
So the loser has to come into the office tomorrow and do Pick Central. Winner comes and does the yak with us and collects their $2,000.
That's epic.
Okay.
All right, wait, I have one more question.
I have some questions as well.
How do you stay sharp during the pandemic? Do you got a skee ball machine at home?
He lives in an arcade.
Yeah. You live in an arcade?
He lives in an arcade.
He owns one.
I have an arcade business. I own 55 skee ball machines.
All right, there we go.
I've got games and bars in Santa Monica and San Francisco. So all over California, I've got games. So plenty of time to practice on my personal lanes.
And you like patterns?
So what's the difference with the machines here?
These are slightly newer, same format, plastic balls, but yeah.
You said plastic balls with a little disdain there.
I'm a wood ball guy.
I thought so. Oh, I could tell the moment I saw
you.
Don't
make any excuses, though. Is that going to be an excuse? Is that a valid excuse?
No, I mean, I qualified for last year's Nationals with plastic balls, and I mean, the ball's round. I roll it.
So when you're talking to the skee ball,
that's inspiring.
The ball's round. I roll it.
Did you meet your wife on the circuit?
So I was hosting a skee ball tournament at a winery in San Francisco, and she came with one of her girlfriends, and played, made it to the semifinals, got the hots, and I asked her out.
Wow.
And there we go.
A tale as old as time, really.
Yeah, there we go.
Now guys, we have a skee ball baby, pussy. So rest is history.
So when you're going up against the skee ball kid and you guys are like going back and forth, maybe a little chirping going on, are you like
you guys try? Trash
are you
talk?
Like I'm, like you're playing on the skee ball machine? I own the skee ball machine.
Yeah, I was. He was.
I own 55 of them, bitch.
He's still got the diapers on, and I'm raising skee ball legends. But
yeah.
So it was friendly before, but now the game faces are on.
Yeah.
It's
that's what we're looking for.
It's I need some bad blood.
Yeah, what is it about being called the cat that makes you want to grow a mustache? Because we got a cat of our own that can't growing a little tickler.
Yeah, I mean, my metaphor is keeping my claws sharp, always on the prowl. Rawr. I'm a predator, so it's rawr. Like,
what's that a metaphor for?
Business, life.
Yes,
you know,
exactly.
You gotta keep your claws sharp.
Dan just has a shallow philtrum.
Yeah. He just doesn't exactly fill in the philtrum.
I don't know what that is, but it hurt my feelings.
So what's the nerves like? Do you get nervous before something like this? Are you just locked in? Are you having fun? Or is it like, I need to perform well?
I mean, at my second national championship, I invited my folks out, and my mom couldn't even watch, right?
Really?
She's, like, stressed out in the back of the knitting factory down the street where that championship was. And, like, I don't know. I'm comfortable under pressure, so I thrive in that.
His circadian rhythm is off.
His circadian rhythm was all fucky. So in wrestling, the groupies are called singlet chasers.
Yes.
Right. Hockey is what?
Puck sluts.
Puck sluts. Is there something for skee ball groupies?
I mean, I don't have a name for that. I mean, we're ski celebrities. That's
yeah.
Scots.
Ski lever skis. That's incredible. There's incredible names Scots. Up here when you look up. Ecstasy.
Barack Rock Roll Obama.
Wayne Gretzky. Do you feel like the obligation to have like a sweet ass name? Do you think that when someone comes onto the circuit, they need to brand themselves well?
I mean, it's called an alter skigo, and it is a rite of passage.
You guys, so you just are you in?
Is there
are
a
you
whole dictionary?
Are you in this for the competition or the puns? Are you in this for the competition or the puns, sir?
He's a pun guy.
Answer
he's
the question.
Linguist. I'm building a brand. I'm building a brand here. I'm trying to put my kid through college because of skee ball. Let's do it.
Let's do it. That's hell right. Yes.
Like community college? What are we talking about?
What kind of online?
Harvard.
He speaks Korean and English.
Oh,
and he's,
fine.
Yeah,
he's
let's go. That's a surefire ticket to a scholarship.
How many kids you got, skee ball kid?
Yeah, skee ball kid.
Yeah.
I hope none.
Man.
But there's a chance.
Yeah.
You hear that, Dad?
He's got a couple ballers running around in the streets.
All right, so what's your prediction?
Cat by one.
Cat by one.
Give us a throw. Give us a throw before you get out of here.
Is it called, wait, is it a throw?
A roll.
It's a roll. Roll.
It's a roll. Come on, Ron. Damn it, Ron.
I sound like Big Cat.
You do sound like Big Cat right now.
Here, we can just... Perfect. That's perfect. Yeah, get over there. And we also heard that you're a 50s guy, that you go for the 50s, that you want to go straight down the middle.
It's a righty.
By the way, if everyone could like this video, if everyone could like it, the stream, that would help. Like the stream.
Yes, sir.
Oh, him. What are you doing? Oh, wow. He's got a whole thing.
He's stretching out.
Nice stretch going.
Hit the button. Not doing anything.
Button's not doing anything. I'm hitting.
Oh, they sound wooden.
They sound wooden.
It's all right. Just go ahead. Are those wooden?
Oh,
wow. Wow.
Folks.
Wow.
Oh, no.
Okay. 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 Wow.
Mr. Kid.
Are there any illegal substances that have taken over the ski ball community?
Wow.
Pass the mic and tell us.
Pass the mic.
Very nice.
Imagine it's
right
an
here,
Adderall
right
issue, maybe.
Yeah, what
alcohol,
are the PEDs
like
of ski ball?
Spider tack.
There's a fun story. I won't go into it, but it was called
Why would you not go into a fun story?
It was called Rosengate. When we go back to the arena, you'll see my photo, like a cloud of rosin dust, and it was a foreign substance that was impacting the balls, just like in any other sport. You know, they're like ripping off baseball pitchers' pants and shit now.
So they banned you?
There was a silent memo that went out and said, you know, no more rosin, no more foreign substances on the lane. That's why I rub my shoes. That's why I was stretching. It's a pre-roll ritual. Mm-hmm.
Check the bottom of his shoes, though. Make sure there's no rosin on the bottom of those shoes there. If he's rubbing his shoes, there might be a glove situation.
No,
a Trevor
nothing.
Bauer.
Ski ball kid, you see that?
Clean hands. Clean hands. Is he okay? Is he okay, kid? The kid gives a
trusting
thumbs up.
Guy.
Kid's dad, less sure about it.
What kind of animal is this?
What's that? This is a white buffalo. This is when you roll 8 into the 50 and 1 into the 40. It's the there's all these nicknames for every roll.
Wait, what else is there?
What about it?
A white buffalo
a dictionary. Of 40s and 50s. You can kind of see them listed up there. It's full circle, cherry, chip, high five, fish. There's all these fun puns. I mean, the founder of Brewski Ball here, Eric Pavone, I mean, the most creative guy I've ever met.
Can
in my
you tell
entire
us about
life.
This venue? What's this venue like?
We're in Full Circle Bar in Brooklyn. There's also one in Austin. This is the home of Brewski Ball. This is where the sport was founded.
Yep.
Everything, all the magic has happened here. I've run around in a leopard print onesie, just like winning national championships in that back
room.
Is this where you won all three of your national championships?
I won one in here, and then one in here, one at the Knitting Factory down the street, and then one in Austin, Texas.
Wow. So it's accountable.
Hell yeah. That's
crazy. And I'm the only guy that has to travel. I mean, like all Brooklyn Rollers, Austin Rollers, they're just like going to their backyard. Ski Ball Kid, Long Island, Edison, New Jersey, whatever. It's like, I came 3,000 miles for this.
Right. That's right. Right. Hell yes, that's brother. Hard. We're excited to have you out here. We can't wait to see you rolling those things.
Yes. Let's
I'm
do
excited.
It.
All right, Joey the Cat. Yeah. Thank you.
Joey the Cat. Joey. Thank
Good stuff,
you.
Joey.
I'm legitimately excited now.
Yeah, I'm pumped.
To talk
I'm
to these
pumped.
Guys.
Can we
I'd love to get Ski Ball Dad
rooting for?
Here.
Yeah, we should
Ski
get
Ski Ball Dad. Let's Ski get Ski Ball Dad over here. By the way, shout out Nick Straight Dad, who's here.
My dad is
very
here.
Yep.
No, that's an actor.
Talking to chicks.
He was so straight. He was telling me about all the wrestlers he likes. And I was like, wow.
He does like a lot.
I think my mic just came unplugged. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah,
you're good.
He's good, right? Nick's good.
Mr.
Nick
Fetterman?
Just tried to kick
Ski Ball Dad, what's going on, sir?
Your straight dad.
I don't want to get grounded. I'm in big trouble. I am.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when did you know your kid was the ski ball kid?
Well, he's been playing since he was young, but probably around 16 is when he started getting really good. And then at 17, he was hitting most of the jackpots. Almost every time he's in a jackpot. And a couple friends, one guy's here tonight, and he said to him, hey, you ever go for the hundreds?
Mm-hmm.
He's like, no, they're hard.
Yeah.
He was like, you're so good at the 40s. Try the hundreds. And he started hitting hundreds. Within an hour, he was hitting hundreds. And he started hitting the jackpots in the larger arcade. 500 points for the jackpot there instead of 300.
Sir.
Wow.
And then they raised it to 600 because he won too much.
Yeah.
And then he came back the next week and they have a sign up saying limit 2 jackpots daily.
No, you
what?
Broke the
Change
system.
The
wow.
That sign's still up today.
Wow. All right. So there's a big, not controversy, but a lot of discussion these days about fathers and their kids, and do they do specialization in sports, like play one sport or play all sports? Did the skee ball kid only play skee ball, or did he play multiple sports?
No,
growing
he was real small growing up.
Yeah,
but he played baseball. He played all the sports.
Okay,
he actually played 2 seasons of travel baseball, as tiny as he was.
Oh, wow.
And 10 of soccer.
So you're saying it's more like let him play every sport, and then they'll find their sport like skee-ball.
He, as he told you before, to become good at this is the same thing he became good at anything else he had to do because he was so small. It was persistence.
Yeah.
And kept at it and figured out what works for you.
Mm-hmm. Just walk in a little bit. They're saying get a shot.
What works for you and keep doing it until you get it right.
I love
it. Right, and one day he could get a scholarship to hell, Kent State.
Yeah. Yes.
He's too big for that.
He had some academic scholarships, but of course he didn't take them, and I had to pay a fortune for his college.
God damn it, skee-ball kid.
That's why you got to win today to make that money back.
That's why you got
to
win.
And I just talked to Big Cat, and he said he was willing to up the prize money.
Stop.
To $10,000. $100,000.
Let's hear it for $100,000.
Big Cat is saving lives.
He did say if it was a perfect game, he would do that.
I was thinking about that, though. I was going to do a cash prize for a perfect game, but then it changes the dynamic of what you're going for. Mm-hmm. Because then you'd like almost want to get a perfect game instead of win the game. So that is off the table.
That's admirable, and you're not concerned about losing money.
I don't want to change the dynamic of the game.
Yeah.
So we likened you to Earl Woods. Tiger Woods' dad. So like Earl Woods, how much pussy do you get?
How much what?
Pussy do you get?
Pussy.
Do I have to ask my wife that question?
There we go.
That's a very good answer.
This
plenty.
Guy, good answer.
Why isn't she here tonight?
My wife is home with my mom and my daughter.
Oh, okay.
My dad's one of the reasons why Elon's been playing. He passed last year.
Don't make us feel bad.
Brandon, that was like the first sentence you said.
They got a big watch party.
0-for-1.
Nobody bats lower than
that. They just have a big watch party going on at home instead.
I just thought she should be here.
How are you so bad?
Brandon, you want to ask how he passed?
We can talk on the side.
Yeah.
So do you still think about him a lot? That's Brandon's next question. Yeah.
What do you think it is that you passed on to your son to make him so great at this? Like, what do you?
Actually, I can tell you. Talk about the persistence. When he was 6 and he started playing baseball, and he was really bad, and he struck out 4 times in one game. So we were practicing every day, and it seemed like he was having a little tough time. So I looked at him. I said, "Am I being a little hard on you?" He's like, maybe a little. I was like, well, you know, when you struck out, did you get upset? He's like, yeah. I said, did you cry? He said, yeah. Remember, he was 6. I'm like, all right. When you struck out, did I get upset? He goes, no. Did I love you enough? He goes, no. I said, all right. Well, you can either practice, get better, or strike out and not get upset. And the next day he walked up to me and said, Dad, can we practice hitting today?
Right. Yeah,
beautiful.
There you go. That's the story. Unbelievable.
Is there a workout regimen? Is it like a wrist strength thing?
That's what I was wondering. Is it a lot of biceps?
Buckets of rice.
Because Sass has been practicing with his wrist, but I don't know if it's the same.
My old man who's here is like his has gotten weak.
It's got very loose.
They're flopping around everywhere.
I'll tell you what it takes. It takes a lot of money in the arcade till you get that good.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yep. Maybe you should own an arcade. Maybe it's time to buy the arcade, like the cat over there.
Yeah. 55 of them.
How many oversized stuffed animals are in your house?
Not anymore. We had 2 or 3.
Okay.
That's
he would win some of those shooting baskets at the
How many finger traps?
Yeah. You have a room for Chinese finger traps.
My sister's 10 years younger. Convincing her to save the tickets and not get those finger traps and wait and get a TV might be a better use of the tickets.
Yeah.
Yes. Very nice.
Finger traps are fun.
Well, best of luck, brother.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Ski ball dad. Cheers.
Ski dad, great guy. Straight shooter.
Great community.
Yeah, it's good to see that. It's good to see family still
good energy
is important
here.
In ski ball.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And good job,
Yak,
Brandon.
As
good
a
job.
Yak unit, though, we have something that was fucked up.
If anybody else has had a family tragedy that Brandon could bring up, come hop on the mic.
Just write it down on a piece of paper. He'll read it out loud.
Yeah.
No, he'll, get it like a mind reader. Like, he'll figure out what your family tragedy is.
I was wondering where the man's lovely wife was. That was all.
Yeah.
But we have something to address as a show. It's Thursday.
Oh,
shit.
Ooh. It's Thursday, and we forgot to tell somebody that we were going to be having a show in Brooklyn.
Wait, we didn't tell him?
No, we didn't tell him. We forgot.
No, all right, so in my defense, which isn't a defense, I'll own it, I was very busy the last 2 days. I was traveling today. And I forgot. I just forgot. I said it out loud on the show.
You said it on the show.
So maybe, actually, can I reverse this and be like, Tank doesn't listen to the show?
So it's his fault?
He only does
a fan of the show.
Because we did say it multiple times.
I said it multiple times this week, and Tank doesn't listen when he's not on. So that's, actually, yeah, I'm going to say that's on Tank.
Okay.
But payback, I'm going to welcome Tank on as many times as he wants next week.
Yeah, we gave him Monday and Thursday.
I'm going to have you on Grit Week.
I'm also going to be away on
Monday. I'm going Monday and Tuesday.
And I'm going Thursday.
I'm also going to be away.
KB and Owen all next week.
Yeah, perfect.
No, I do
Are you
feel
out
bad.
Too?
That was a sad tweet to like come across.
Oh, he tweeted it out?
Yeah, he was like, no yak today. No one told me. I was like, God damn it.
So I walked past the green room today, and Tank was just sitting in there with Roan on the couch filming a soda review. And I walked past, I just hear, Nick. He didn't pluralize my name, so I knew something was wrong. I turn around and I walk back in, and he said, so today on the yak, I'm like, oh, fuck.
And it was a setup.
Yeah, it was a
setup. He already knew the answer.
Mm-hmm.
You should have just done a show.
We should have just done a show.
The cameras.
Yeah, just done it.
All right, so I'll own up to that. I'll apologize.
I'll own a little bit. I already apologized to him on behalf of all of us, saying we should have our camp and the Frank the Tank camp should have been in more of a contact over this.
I honestly haven't seen him this week like more than once or like one.
He hasn't been in. He hasn't been in much. I don't think.
So, I'll own it.
He's been in every single day for like 12 hours.
But I haven't been in. I was only in on Monday.
That's my desk.
I was only in on Tuesday and Wednesday.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm going to go with.
It's not fair, but you came from far and wide today. Brandon came from far and wide today. Where'd you come from, Brandon?
Norwalk, Connecticut.
What was going on there?
I went to WWE headquarters.
With?
Triple H and Stephanie.
That's fucking badass.
Yeah, that is awesome. Badass.
Brandon. So where was the exact address of that?
I just went to Connecticut, brother. I went to Connecticut.
Oh, I like that, brother.
What's the WWE warehouse?
No, I went to the headquarters. I didn't go to...
All right.
Okay. I went to Connecticut. It was cool.
But like, if I wanted to go to where you went today, where would
I
go?
Not really something they publicize there,
brother.
Where are you going after this?
I'm going home.
What's that address?
Where's that?
Where is that?
Give us an address. Just throw us a little bit. Throw us a bone one time.
And I won't be here next week. I'll be going to SummerSlam, so it's going to be great.
That's going to be awesome.
Great time.
Oh, you don't have to vax out there?
He's vaxxed. Brandon's vaxxed.
Brandon is vaxxed.
Very.
Those vaxxed and waxed.
Incredibly vaxxed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's fully waxed. Brandon, when are you leaving for SummerSlam? That's going to be sick.
I'm leaving, I think, Monday or Tuesday.
That's going to be awesome.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Roan, we haven't talked about this. You got suspended from Twitter.
Oh, yeah. What happened?
I got big time suspended
from
Twitter today. No, I'm not at all. And it wasn't even for a DMCA. I was like, I figured I have a DMCA for filming my television during like a basketball highlight or something like that. But it wasn't even a DMCA. I got something I'd never even heard of before. It was I had violated the rules against platform manipulation and spam. So
astroturfing?
That sounds like some shit you do.
But what kind of platform manipulation could I even be in trouble for?
Don't even get me started.
There's nothing that I could have done that would actually get me in trouble other than telling people to listen to Son of a Boy Dad because Lil Sass is in the hospital. And
that's all I could think of. I don't know anything else. I mean, I think you'll get it back. Do you not care?
KB, let me look at your head.
Is KB looking slick?
It's not that bad.
Not that bad?
He's pretty damp.
Yeah, visibly
sweaty.
Yes. Okay, the answer's yes. Sorry.
What's wrong, KB? What? Just sweat it out.
Did you talk to Gaz?
I talked to Gaz.
Ron, you told someone to kill themselves, which is against the rules.
I did not tell them.
Really?
He didn't tell them, he asked.
KMS.
Yeah, no, you can't even say that.
I just requested politely that AOC kill herself.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
Okay. When was this?
Okay. It was yesterday.
No, that couldn't be.
You're about to get a one-week
suspension. Was that your last tweet?
I just wanted her to do it.
Yeah, cool. Just a
which
prank.
I understand. But
you understand at least a little bit.
Did you?
No, I've never said anything like that. I've never acted in such a foul manner. I don't know what it was.
Huh.
I don't know.
I was
lying.
Telling Roan today. Twitter updated the terms of service, and now they can just says we can suspend you or delete your account for no reason.
Huh?
Yeah.
That must have been because Jay Cutler just joined.
I know.
It was Jay Cutler's fault.
I know.
This is my first time in Williamsburg. Did you guys see how many Mies there are? It's astounding.
What? Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah,
I'm
so not, many of
I'm fucking everywhere.
Yeah.
Yes.
But somehow
first time. This is your,
haven't been.
They were all. This is your spot.
I think I've been avoiding me.
Yeah.
But they don't like you here, though.
Not at all. It's a weird thing. I don't fit like in you. Anywhere.
There's you everywhere, and they don't like you. None of you likes you.
Boy, does it suck.
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question? Why is your dad hiding behind that burly man in the corner over there?
Let's get your dad on. Let's get dad on.
He won't do it. He won't do it. He won't do it.
I swear to God, it's a paid act.
Will?
Yeah, it's definitely like a TaskRabbit dad.
Just say hi.
Will, watch just you slide over here, second. Slick.
Why? Hey. What's wrong?
He looks so...
It's
he looks
not
so
like there is an audience.
He's so broad in his chest. Yeah. Like, he's so jacked.
Yeah, that's a genetic
in
thing.
In a way that Nick is not.
He told me, what did he say, the three things he taught you?
Wasn't a fucking joke.
The three things he taught you, confidence, effort, and...
And don't take any shit since I was a kid. Yeah. And I do
all three.
I know confidence.
His dad was,
I've never tried in my life.
His dad was telling it to me like he like instilled it all in Nick. He's like, yeah, what'd I tell you, boy? And Nick was like, meekly was like, confident.
Like he's Yogi Berra.
The only thing I've seen today is my shoes. I just looked down.
They're everywhere. Your shoes are everywhere you look. It's insane. He won't come on, though? No dad?
Well,
he
was very clear about definitely not doing that. So I'm in big trouble.
He said, don't make fun of me.
Yeah. I would never.
Fair.
I've never done it.
Yes, never done it. All right, I can do this quick ad. When you need to. Wait, am I reading this exactly?
Yeah, read it. You got to read
it. Yes, all right.
Maybe another round of Coors Lights? Maybe?
We're sponsored by Coors Light. Open a Coors Light. It's Mountain Cold Refreshment. Made to chill. It tastes great. Can I get another one? Tastes great from Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. So slow down and celebrate responsibly. Get to Coors Light in the new look delivered straight to your door with Drizzly or an Instacart by going to CoorsLight.com/take. Look at that. The new, see that?
Harry.
Yeah.
Thirsty, buddy.
And I've been having these since I was 10, 11. Oh, I'm in trouble.
MB's about to kill you. Thank you to Coors Light, though, for sponsoring this. It is the most delicious beer in the world.
Take that away from him, MB.
I love Coors Light.
Yeah, they're phenomenal.
I just golfed. I just golfed with Coors Light on Monday.
Don't let him have that, MB.
I was that video's coming out on Monday.
Is that the late 30s
move? I
wasn't drinking
that. They were no, it was for a video.
Thank you.
What is it?
Thank you.
What?
Take that away from him.
Take that away from Sass, so he's not even tempted.
Yeah.
They took it away
that's
from me.
That's why Coors Light's so good, you'll want to drink it underage.
Nick, please.
How long do we have to sponsor for?
5 more minutes? done right now. We've had a hell of a run. Unbelievable run. I'm trying to figure out what this is shot like because this is such an interesting,
it's
like,
a movie.
It's an incredible lighting. It's these, like, this bright, warm lighting, but just these.
What is it?
These
guys are significantly better than our team.
There's a documentary
that's an incredible
being made
camera.
Tonight, too. So there's a documentary that we will be in.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to be in a doc.
Yes.
Yeah.
Whether it was a serial killer one or a ski ball competition.
You'd be getting killed, right? That's what you're talking about. You would be getting smoked.
I'm super murderable.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
Shut up.
Your dad, on the other hand, though.
Not murderable at all.
Impossible to kill.
Shut up.
All right, so who's everyone rooting for tonight?
Kid. Oh, yeah, let's do a Lee Corso. Yeah. Do we have big heads?
I'm going with the old guy.
You're going with the cat.
I'm going with the cat. I'm going with the old guy.
I might be going with the cat, too.
Cat?
I'm Futterman. I'm
Futterman. I
got to
go with the cat.
Yeah,
I'm also
going
just
with
rooting
the
for the guy who last lost. Like, I want to see parody in the skee ball.
I guess I could root for the kid whose grandfather died.
No. You already danced on his grave.
You already did.
Yeah.
See, the thing is, like, you want the kid to win because he's younger.
Why?
What?
Kyle wants
what?
To win.
That's
me.
He's
shorter
spoken
than
like a
21-year-old. Is Futterman shorter than me?
But the cat, I think the cat's going to win.
You do?
Based off of those shots that he was throwing or rolling.
Yeah. I feel like
he hit almost all of those.
The skee ball kid was kind of sandbagging, though.
Oh, yeah.
But
he
also
was doing
he
was sticking around left-handed and right-handed.
Lefty-righty.
Yeah.
The cat made more shots. The kid's shots were worth twice as much.
They both had 200.
That's what I mean.
There were 450s and 2 100s.
Yeah.
So.
We're tricked by the volume.
And how many throws do they get?
I don't want either to have to be on pick central.
Right. Right.
Their career's over before
I wouldn't wish that on my worst.
We got to, by the way, when we do have the loser on pick central tomorrow, we have to let them know before we leave tonight that they should just antagonize Rico and be like, I'm a new gambling guy.
Yeah. I'm
here to take your job.
We should have
Rico
try
to squeeze out this random skee ball.
We should have the loser. We should have the loser go in, and then we should also have Nadu come in.
Yes.
So it's like they just don't even know what they got themselves into. It's
just
a shit show. And they have to sit there the entire time.
We also have, by the way, tomorrow, Nick is out. Brandon's out. I think it's me, Roan, KB, Owen, and Sass.
I'm out as well.
You're out.
Yeah.
All right, so me, Owen, KB, and Roan. We have the winner of this, and then we have Bobby Lang, who's going to be in studio
the
as
rough
well.
Rough and rowdy heavyweight champion.
Fighting Pac-Man, yeah.
Rough and rowdy heavyweight champ.
By as well.
Nice.
So it'll be a good show.
Star-studded show.
Mm-hmm. Can he be on Pick Central too?
No.
No, fuck. No, no.
We only
no.
losers star-studded. On Pick Central.
You're not even on tomorrow. Why do you care?
I don't know.
Where are you going, Brandon?
I'm just going to be out tomorrow. It's going to be out.
Oh, WWE?
Yeah.
You're heading back
yeah.
to the where? To
that's
the
where
family?
I'm going. Going to Norwalk, Connecticut. It's going to be beautiful.
Oh, really?
I mean, the last time Brandon was out without an excuse, there was a raid on the Capitol. So if history...
if history so happens to repeat itself.
I mean,
itself.
History has a funny way of repeating uh-huh. itself.
You and Jack Mack.
Yeah. Is this true, Brandon?
I mean, you know.
That did happen.
Confirm or deny. All right, so KB, this is your, like, night. So you're rooting for Skee-Ball Kid?
I am, yes.
So you... It was one day on the yak. We said, would you rather be the best in the world at something or have $3,000?
It was much less.
All right.
It was like $20.
And
it,
you,
it was
and
double
you,
digits.
And you went and looked digits. Up these guys, and then you became obsessed with skee
yeah,
ball.
So
you're
curious,
like,
who is the best skee ball player in the world? Because I know who the best Dance Dance Revolution player
okay. Shut up.
And he's famous for something else. But I was very curious. And we discovered him, Elon Futterman, Skee-Ball Kid, and I've been obsessed with him ever since. And here, this is my big moment.
This is
this
surreal.
Is your
this is
it's
your
surreal
day.
To see it's a crowd day. Of nine right yeah. in front of my face.
These are your obsessions. Yeah. So
but
like
it's by far your most innocent obsession.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, in 2 months,
this is
KB's
going
to be like, hey, I want to do this live show from a flight simulator. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I don't know about that, KB.
The 20th anniversary.
Hey, can we get some box cutters?
This is a prank on a show?
This is your most innocent obsession.
It is. Mm. It's beautiful. I'm happy for you. I'm thank happy you that guys. We're here. I'm happy we're doing
so we have Kat, Kid. We need the rest of who you guys are pulling for.
I'm Kat.
Here
your cat.
Nick.
Why are you kid?
He's youthful. And his dad is
a dad's sweet boy.
Yeah. Roan's got a little bit of he's in his grooming phase with young men.
Yeah, yeah I got that. Sass just sitting over my knee, just ready to powder that ass. I got
Sass,
told
you
today.
Have to go the different. You have to go the opposite way. Go cat.
You got to be rebellious.
I just said I was going cat.
Okay.
Okay, nice. So
Owen, right. Who are you with?
So we'll
I'm
sit.
Kid.
We'll
kid.
Sit on the bleachers corresponding with that.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then we'll each put like 5% of our yearly salary on it. So
perfect.
I'll put like $300. Mm-hmm. Dan, you'll put how much is that?
Ask him. See if Sass knows.
A lot.
A lot.
Sass out.
All right. So how much time we got? 13 minutes.
45
minutes. 13 minutes? 13 minutes? This has been flying
yak.
By.
We've been going for 10 damn. Minutes.
13, yeah.
2-hour yak? Should we do it? Let's do a draft.
Oh, anybody have ingredients?
Let's do a beer draft.
I'm going to take Coors first.
I want Coors. No, I want Coors.
I'm going to take Coors first.
Oh, that's fair.
Sass? This place is
and I'm
going to
have too much.
Heineken Zips.
No.
Not overconsumption. Don't overconsume. Please don't overconsume.
Oh, man.
Please stop.
Yeah, I will.
We also have...
this is Coors is the part of my take beer. And I'm pretty sure this is a dual promo.
What's the anus yeah. beer?
There's nothing that the anus boys like more than ruining money.
It's ironic.
Misery loves yeah. company.
They are the indie
come
band that's like, we'll never sell
you, bro.
Out.
Yeah.
It's ironic. Let them enjoy themselves.
Funny. It's cool if we all
come on,
lose
man.
Our jobs. Yeah.
Who are your sponsors? We'll ruin your sponsors real fast.
Well, we already ruined them ourselves. We lost Dude Wipes because we said it's cooler to put more shit in your ass.
They should get that.
Yes, that is funny.
They should be able
the,
to
the only way
that.
To be more masculine is not wiping your ass.
Yeah. Why don't we... in this last little set, why don't we get a couple throws in? Why don't the
yeah.
boys get a couple
yeah.
throws in?
Yeah.
Brandon, why don't you chuck one? Like,
yeah,
you're
Brandon,
here. You're right by it. Let's see if you can get that hunji.
Let's see who's got the best.
That what? That
whoever has let's do whoever has the lowest score has to buy lunch when we're all back together.
Oh. Yes. How many throws? How many throws?
Nine. I think it's nine.
If
nine throws. Yeah, nine.
Also,
throws.
Can I ask, how do these matches take an hour and a half?
Because it's nine throws is one frame. and it's 10 frames.
That, Jesus Christ.
My God.
That's not right at all.
Yes, it is right. Is that not
right? How about three throws?
What did I say? Did I say that right?
Is that right?
I'm pretty sure.
Did you say the score was 419 to 412?
Where's Futterman's crazy?
Nine
ass.
Throws is one frame,
so
10 frames, best of
game?
Five.
How's a perfect game happen? You have to
no,
hit.
No one does perfect games. People do perfect frames.
Perfect frames.
So they get 900.
Has a perfect game ever been done?
Perfect frame?
No, well, just. Well, yeah, I was, but I didn't want to. I didn't want to. Sully the,
so
yeah,
I don't want to go first just because I'm close. Why don't we have a draft? We have some sort of lottery here and see who goes first.
Let's do a draft. All right, so let's do a draft.
The loser has to buy lunch, and what does the second loser have to do?
Has to eat the entirety
of the lunch. Yeah, that's perfect.
That's actually a pretty good one.
Yep, that's a thing.
That's perfect.
There it is.
So you almost don't want to be second to last.
How do we draft to figure out the order that we're rolling?
Yeah, let's take 30 minutes to do a Yankee swap to figure out who does the draft.
Just don't want to go first. So we'll figure it out.
All right, so someone else go. KB, go. This is your night.
Let's go,
go
KB. Let's go, KB. Get some noise for KB. All nine throws, or how about just three?
Hit the button.
Let's do
hit the button,
three.
Hit the
button.
We'll do three.
Three throws.
Three throws.
Free throws or three?
Oh my God.
Wow.
The fuck
shockingly bad. Shockingly bad.
Three throws.
So that's zero.
Gross.
Okay, that's
KB.
Ten.
You know, people can see.
One more.
One more.
Wait, was that a 20 or a 10? Oh, it looks like 20. Why does it say 20? It was a 10.
Kyle,
oh,
what the fuck? What just happened?
He's got 40.
Let's go, Kyle.
Let's go, Kyle.
Get up there, Owen.
Go ahead.
Kind of a strategic move, though, because I think he's thinking that we're not going to get any of them.
That will get you last.
Oh, I think you want to be last. You don't want to be second to last to have to eat all the lunch.
Oh, yeah, we didn't think about this at all.
Yeah, but buying the lunch.
I'd rather eat the lunch than
Let's go, Brandon. Brandon's up now.
All the lunch.
You don't even know what we're buying.
True.
KB got 40.
Okay,
Brandon's got 50. Brandon's got
90, 110.
70.
I won't be able to do this math much longer.
Oh, wow.
70. What did you get?
40. I will. I'll try my best. My dad's going to be so disappointed in me.
Hold that beer. I got you.
Again.
All right, Brandon, remember your score.
70.
You have 40.
Did I really?
Yes. You missed the first one. You got two 20s. Or no, two 20s. That's a 20. That's a 20. That's 60.
60.
Wow, Roan.
Way to go.
Give it up for Roan.
Nick, let's go, Nick.
All right, Nick.
I'm going the Futterman way. I'm going for hundreds.
Yes.
Oh,
uh-oh.
So your first throw is what you're going to try and come in last on purpose right here.
Your first
throw. He's wrapped up. He's wrapped up. He's tangled.
Yeah. Okay, that's 10.
10 for Terrani.
Oh! Hey!
110 for 10. Nick.
Where's my dad?
Hey! Where's my dad?
Let's go.
Oh, daddy. No.
Never enough for Mr. Terrani. Your dad just left when you missed that second one.
He left.
He walked right out.
No. Right at the gut. Right at the gut.
Wait, you know, you have to restart it.
Why? No, you're good. Oh, you're
double
good.
Score.
That's fine. You can keep your own score. 20.
No!
Big cat.
40?
No, isn't
no, 50.
It?
No, 50. So you're second to last
so
right now.
So Kyle is in last.
Someone wants to
Great
eat all
strategy,
the
KB.
Yeah, thank you. Oh, you want me to go?
I'll just buy the lunches.
Shit. Owen will just buy the lunch. No, Owen, go. Roll.
I don't want to eat all the lunches.
All right, Sass.
Fuck.
Through the wires. Let's go, Sass. Make some noise for
Let's
Sass.
Let's make some noise for the King of
hey,
New York.
Sass. Sass.
That's right.
Now you're Whoa. In New York.
Okay.
20. Nice. Hundo. Go hundo hunting.
I 100% know Sass
That's
is going to think he got
go
injured.
Go hundo
after
hunting.
This.
That's
going to have an ailment.
Dude, my fucking arm.
Oh, that's 40. So it's a tie.
Tie.
It's
got
a roll off.
A roll off. Yes, we need a roll.
Owen, are you going?
Ski
have you gone?
Ski off.
Oh, we gotta go.
That guy's angry.
Oh, Owen still has to go.
Go.
You have to go. You have
Owen,
to go.
Owen, come on.
Because Owen, if you get below 40,
you're buying
then
lunch.
You're buying lunch.
Come on, sweet boy.
Ski off for
the angle's a lot more strange than you'd think it would
it
be.
It is, right?
Yeah.
Not for me.
Not for a guy like me. Owen got 20.
20. 320. One more 20. 30.
Hey,
okay.
That's it.
We have
good,
a,
you're good.
We have a fucking ski off.
Ski off.
Hey, holy shit.
All right, so this is for loser of this.
Wait.
Has to buy the lunch. And then
winner
eats it all.
Wait, let's do one ball.
Okay, one ball.
A one ball ski off.
One ball ski off.
Golden ball. The golden ball. Who's going first? Who's going first? KB, you want to go first?
Yeah, you go first.
No,
what
you
are you
going to
go for?
You guys go one ball to see who goes first.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense.
Yes, one ball.
That's
higher score goes first.
Higher score goes first.
Oh, Jesus. KB's out.
On his special night.
Sash,
try again. Go
no,
again.
No, Sash goes first.
My
now.
Hit percentage
Sass
on this is 99.
First. This counts, Sash. This
That's
counts.
The first time I've ever seen you.
So
mess
it's
that
this
up.
Throw, and then you get one more.
Yeah.
You lost the.
You're lucky your
oh,
dad
boy,
isn't here,
look
Kyle.
At this. Look at this. The guy's going oh, for it.
Oh, no. Okay.
All right.
10.
So wait, no. This is just for who goes first.
This, no, Sass no. First. He already lost. Sass, oh yeah, Sass, you go first now.
Sass
go.
Goes first.
Yeah, because you won that. You had the better score.
That's true.
Good luck.
All right, good luck, Sass. All right,
Sass.
Go Sassy.
Oh.
Same thing. It's brutal. All
right.
Kyle, all you have to do.
Damn.
You're going to be buying, pretty much.
Yeah.
Sass is about to eat.
All right,
you just
here
gotta
we go.
Oh, he got it. There it is.
Uh-oh.
Redemption.
Uh-oh. No, swag.
Was that
20?
Yes.
Was that
20? That's 20. 20.
Hey.
Now he has, so he has
so
to eat.
You
all.
Have to buy.
You have to
yes
buy.
Eat
he has
all.
To
all
eat.
Right. I'm just going to do McDonald's.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
For so everyone.
But, no, but it has to be six meals.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Seven meals.
Kyle eats it all. Che, Kyle you hungry?
Let's yeah make it eight.
Yeah, we'll make it eight.
All right, are we good to go? Oh, no, we got 4 minutes. How did that take that long? Or is that short? God, I thought
man
that was like I
that
took
an
20
hour
minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. We have nothing left.
That was all of our material.
That was brutal. I really thought it, we like, it
was
like
that
was
a great send-off, and now we're just
wait,
going out.
What about the
whip
new logo? We got to at least give a little bit of credit
oh, yeah
to the new logo.
Wait,
we
oh,
have
yeah
Sass on the new
Sass
logo.
On the new Sass logo.
We have Owen on the new logo. And Owen looks like Dory from yes Finding Nemo. His eyes are so far apart on his head.
Just
I've never seen two eyes that far apart.
Well, that's so he can see up predators easier.
It's a great lesson.
Side of his head.
If you bitch enough, you'll get anything in life.
Roan got
oh,
suspended
right
from Twitter. Brandon may be late. And then what's?
Nope.
Brandon may be late because where was
nope
he?
Nope.
What?
Let's skip over. Let's definitely
one
skip over that one.
Wait, Steven's prep sheet? Did he?
Yeah, he put. Yeah,
such
like
a strange.
Steven, you thought we were going to just talk about that here? At
the you think that's the time and place to talk
what
about that?
Heavy hitting topics. Do you think we were going to get into?
Oh Jesus!
Are onion ski rings delicious or
you
gross?
You want to talk about Darfur too?
Yeah,
say
why
it
don't
out
we
loud
do that?
Darfur is old at this point. Let's talk about something more.
Yeah, it was.
Jay,
you know,
today's just different
for the okay comedy show.
Yeah, come on, guys.
Yeah, you know we'll get into it off camera because it's explosive. Because
we have a lot of
we have a lot of shit to say.
Yeah.
We got all the time
to
world
get off our chest that we can't necessarily.
Well, Sass, do some stand-up to end
yeah, Sass,
yeah
do
no
three jokes.
Give us a five, Sass.
I'm not doing it.
Let's go, Sass.
No, there's no way I'm doing
do
that.
Do one joke.
Work the crowd.
Look at this guy.
All right,
come
I'll
on
do
one
joke.
Joke.
I'll do one joke.
Joke. One joke. One joke.
All right, Big Cat, did you just mention Nickelback?
Yeah. Wait, yeah. Wait, yeah, he did. He was
yeah
just talking about
you know how they got their name, right?
How?
How?
They went to their first show, and everyone wanted their Nickelback.
No, you ruined the show. You ruined the show.
Their
how
first,
did you fuck
their
up that
first
joke
show cost
you've
a nickel.
You've heard that joke
100
times.
We've
back
listened to that 1,500 times.
I know.
Take Sass off of the
graphic. I don't
put
remember
Frank
it
on there.
Get Frank back on
Frank
there.
Oh Frank
let's
on
bring out
graphic
Frank. Let's bring out Caleb. Let's bring out all of our heavy hitters.
Yeah.
They're back
yeah
there.
They're back.
Caleb
they're
shot age 86.
Yeah.
Yes.
Bro, you're
pretty
about
sick,
to get 86
right
from this show, brother.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean we're too oh close where it's like that's like a hey. All right.
Let's just jump into this contest early.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do
right
it to
let's
it now. I can't wait for this.
$2,000 up for grab. World Championship.
$20,000.
The kid versus the cat. The loser has to suffer through Pick Central, and the winner is going
a
to be our special guest
Central
tomorrow.
That is the worst
on
one
the Yak. And we're looking forward to it. So stay, keep watching right here. We're about to go to the bleachers and watch it with everyone at home. We'll be – is there mics back there, Steven, or no? We'll just be heckling.
You'll hear us.
You will hear us.
Our
seats
are roped off. I'm going to have to whip a hipster's ass.
You're going to have to whip a hipster's ass.
Hipsters don't even exist anymore.
There's like three of them right there.
That's not it.
I think those guys are handsome.
He's got a Budweiser Knicks
man
shirt.
right there.
Yeah, come on. He's got a Budweiser Knicks shirt.
Guys, young Arnold Palmer on his shirt.
No, these guys aren't hipsters. Brandon thinks anyone under 30 is a hipster.
Yeah, anyone with that mustache.
These fucking hippies. All right, so stay tuned. Don't do anything.
Stay tuned. Let's go.
We're going in the back. All right.